I kept trying to get her to even come visit sometimes when she wouldn't.
And even when he would ask after a month went by, I still would say, God himself would have to tell me that I need to be with you. Hey crew, welcome back to our channel. My name is Stacy.
And my name is DJ, and this is After The Vows, where we have real deal conversations about marriage. So if you like content like that, make sure you hit that subscribe button below. And today we're talking about, is it unchristian for married couples to separate? Let's talk about it. So we all know that 50% of all marriages end in divorce, but according to marriage.com, 87% of the couples that separate end in divorce, and then 13% of those wind up reconciling back together. We are happy to tell y'all we are part of the 13%.
Yes.
So we're still in the top 50% of the divorce thing. So we're hanging in there.
Way to look at the cup is half full.
Because it's like, 75% empty.
Because we definitely did separate for a few months.
Yeah, we did. So do you think it is unchristian for married couples to separate?
I would say yes and no, because I feel like sometimes God will separate you so that you can grow and see where he wants you to be individually. That way, when you come back, he's edified in your marriage because you both have grown separately and you know who you are. You've hopefully seeked him while you were separated, because I know that's what we did. We definitely got in our word. We prayed more, worshiped more than we ever did when we were together.
Yeah.
Okay, wait, pause. I don't agree that God will separate you. It wasn't God that separated us. It was the sin that separated us. We had to make the decision to separate because of sin, not because of God. Because like the scripture said, what God put together, that no man put asunder, not even including us as husband and wives. So we made a bad decision, but because of the love of God, we had his grace and mercy. And that's what brought us back together. That's us seeking him and trying to come back to the right direction is what helped us to reconcile. So no, it wasn't that God separated us at all. I just had to clarify that. Okay, back to the video.
I believe God will definitely put you in a place to build a closer relationship with him. And then you come back to your spouse so that you can have a stronger marriage and a stronger foundation to edify his kingdom. Definitely.
Yeah, I agree. I actually don't think it is unchristian, depending on the reason why you're doing it. Obviously, if you're separating because you want to go test the waters or something like that, then that is completely unchristian. Mm-hmm. So whenever it says that you should always come together, except when you separate to devote yourselves to prayer for a time or something like that, mm-hmm. and then you come back together.
Right.
And I feel like that's what we did. You know, we separated ourselves to devote ourselves to God and get right, because sometimes you can get too close to the forest to see the trees, and you don't really, you know, appreciate what you have. You don't, you don't see clearly the blessing that God has on you because you're too caught up in whether somebody or not wash the dishes. And that wasn't what we went through. We didn't go through like infidelity or abuse or anything like that.
Mm-hmm.
But, we did have to get clear vision from God.
Right.
You know, as to where we're supposed to be in our marriage. Like, is this really for us?
I don't want to come off as though, I mean, new subscribers, hello. But to our old crew who've been rocking with us, y'all know we are, like, so transparent.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't want to come off to the new people like, oh, that it seems like they came together and made a decision. We're going to separate and go seek God. And that's not what happened. It was not a good situation that happened, and then we both felt so lost,
mm-hmm.
that we had to seek God before mm-hmm. we could have any dealings with each other.
Let me definitely preface this by saying we are not perfect. That's why we used to say in our beginning that we give advice And we kind of stopped saying that because I don't think we really have advice to give. Mm-hmm. It's just us having conversations about it. And you guys can take, you know, what you will from it. Mm-hmm. Relate, don't relate. If you disagree, say it in the comments. We'll definitely read them. But we're by no means perfect. We know by no means have it all figured out.
Right, and we are not telling y'all to leave your marriage.
Yeah. Oh, no, separate. We're not saying that. You know,
no.
That was just marriage. A choice we made for us. May not be necessary for you, but I don't feel like, my thing is, I want to lift the burden of sinfulness off of separation, especially if you're doing it for a reason that edifies God. Your intention is in the right place.
I think as long as you end up there, as long as you know that is your only hope for reconciliation and praying for restoration in your marriage.
Mm-hmm. We went to counseling. I seen therapists by myself. She seen therapists by herself. You seen a counselor by yourself.
Counselor.
And we seen a counselor together. So we put in a lot of money, time, effort. And I feel like we are more of a godly household than we've ever been. Our kids prayed today. Like, we didn't even pray for the breakfast this morning. All three of our kids prayed for the food. It was just like, okay, let them have it because they did such a good job. But that's the culture that we've been setting in our house of praying and knowing where our blessings come from and knowing who's the head of our household. So, you know, we're not perfect now. That's not what I'm saying. We still got a lot of work to do. And we're still kind of processing that situation, both of us, you know. But I think we can rest assured confidently knowing that we are putting God first, each individually. And we get peace from that. Well, I get peace from that, you know, knowing that you seek God and not your own, you know, agenda, because your agenda was not for us to work out.
So you completely
put yourself aside to edify God. And, you know, that shows me what type of person I'm married. And that's the reason why I married you, because I know I'm not perfect. And, you know, I do want to be the leader of this household, but it takes a woman that has her priorities in order for that to happen, because if we're both, you know, running astray, then yeah, our kids are screwed.
Right. So I think I spent a lot of nights praying for discernment. Mm-hmm. And then I saw how you were running after God, and that's the only thing that started giving me a little bit of confirmation and peace. If I didn't feel the peace when I came here, I wouldn't have stayed.
Okay. And she was clear on that. She said that I kept trying to get her to even come visit sometimes when she wouldn't. So again, like, I can't even stress that enough. We went through a process, y'all. I know we are wrapping up 6 months of our lives in a 30-minute video. So I don't know, maybe some things don't make sense to y'all here and there. But rest assured that we went through a real process. So we ask that you guys continue to pray for us. I love y'all. I love the crew. I know y'all always pray for us. Y'all been praying for us since 2013 when we started this channel. So we're definitely grateful for y'all. We ask for your continued prayers. And y'all, just let us know in the comments what you think about the subject. If you have a testimony yourself you want to share, definitely feel free. Don't feel pressured to do it, but we love the community that we have here, that everybody's so hot, humble, open, and transparent. Shouts out to Transformation Church. But, you know, we love that everybody is like that, and we're just so appreciative of that and our community that we have here. So, that being said, I wasn't sure if we would ever finish this video. It seemed like that's a whole lot of story to wrap up in one video, but maybe we did a good job, maybe we didn't. Like I said, leave a comment below and make sure you subscribe to this channel for more conversations like this. We keep it real here. So if you like conversations like this, make sure you hit that subscribe button below. My name is DJ.
And my name is Stacy.
Out there.
Mm.